everybody, and I just thought I would do a quick intro to this week's vlog. Well, actually, this week's vlog is last week's vlog. You may have noticed, or you may not have noticed, that there wasn't a weekly vlog that went up last week, and I had filmed, and what you're going to see in the coming 30 or so minutes is the vlog from the week before last. I actually took last week off. It was a bit of an impromptu, last minute decision. Had a really, really difficult week. Obviously, Bronte went back to Leicester last week, as you'll see in this vlog. But also, we had a few family issues that we had to iron out as well. So it meant that I had a really difficult emotional week last week and just didn't film anything and couldn't edit this vlog either. So I just needed to take a little bit of time out. Excuse the drilling on in the background. I think next door are having some work done. So I hope you'll forgive me for that, and yeah, what you're going to see now in the next half hour or so is actually not last week's vlog, but the week before, and I will be filming again this week. Things are getting back to normal now, and hopefully from here on in, things will be fine. So yeah, so please forgive me for not uploading last week. Hope you didn't miss me too much, and yeah, enjoy the vlog. Good morning and happy Monday, and welcome to Stitched Up Weekly episode 25. So today's Monday, I'm all ready for work, wearing my new dress, and yeah, I'm only at work this morning, and then I am going to get this mop sorted out. I've got an appointment this afternoon, 1 o'clock, thank the Lord, for my hair doing and my extension sorting. So hopefully by the next time you see me, I'll be looking all glam again. And yeah, so I am just working this morning. And yeah, so that's going to be my day today. I did give you a glimpse of this in last week's vlog. This is the Peppermint Patterns button-up dress, and I really like this style, but it doesn't suit me. I'm wearing it with a belt cinching my waist at the minute, so let me just put you down somewhere and I will show you how it looks. Right, so there you go. So yeah, I'm wearing it with a belt that's just cinches in my waist, but essentially it's sleeveless with princess seams and button up front. And if I just take the belt off, you'll see what I mean. It's just, you know, I just think it's a bit shapeless. I mean, bearing in mind that it is actually far too big for me, it's really, really roomy. I do like it, but let's just get this belt back on. I should have known when I picked this style that I knew this style wouldn't do anything for me at all. But yeah, it is very, very big. Now, I did go by my measurements, but I have lost some weight, so maybe I've lost a little bit more in inches because I haven't re-measured myself. That's the thing for the last couple of weeks, but it is quite roomy on me. I could go down at least one size, possibly two, from the size that I chose. The instructions were really good. It sewed up absolutely fine, and I love this fabric. This is a linen cotton mix that I got from Walton's on Friday when I nipped, and yeah, it was a little bit involved, mainly because of the facing, and I might do a sew along for this. I know that I keep saying I'm going to do sew alongs and I haven't got around to it, but I'm going to have more time soon, because I don't know if I mentioned last week, but the locum that I'm doing on a Monday and a Tuesday is finishing at the end of July, and I'm really pleased that the decision has finally been taken out of my hands. I think those of you that have been watching my weekly vlogs for a while know that I've been a bit tormented by it, and I think I had sort of made the decision a couple of weeks ago that I was going to work Mondays and Tuesdays up till the end of July, and then just drop to Mondays until we go on holiday at the end of August, and then that's that. Well, they've actually recruited a nurse practitioner now, so which is really good. I'm really pleased for them. They did say they were disappointed that I wouldn't take the job, but it's just too far for me to go there as an employed person. You know, 2 days a week. I don't mind doing it for a few months, but you know, as you know, I'm fed up of doing it now, and I've been doing it since the beginning of February, so that means I'll have my Mondays and Tuesdays free every week again, which will be lovely. So it means that I will be able to get around to doing those sew-alongs and the tutorials that I'd planned to do, which is really good. So I am going to do the wide leg pants again,
the third time lucky, and I think I'll probably do a tutorial for this as well, because although it's a straightforward dress, the facing to get it to all fit properly and be totally enclosed can be a little bit fiddly if you are a little bit of a beginner. So I thought I would do a tutorial for this one as well, because it's a free pattern and we all love free patterns, don't we? Right, anyway, I need to finish my coffee and finish packing my bag and get off to work, and hopefully I might see you later tonight with my new locks. Take care and have a good day.
6 hours this has taken, but oh my word, what a journey that was. But anyway, it's done. Extensions are back in, hair is recoloured, and it's been cut as well, and I feel human again. It looks so much better. I'm so pleased with it. It was a bit of a nightmare, because you remember me mentioning those matted areas, and it took 2 hours to untangle my hair basically, but bless her, she did an amazing job, and yeah, it's done. So I'm really pleased with it, really like it, and I feel human again. So hopefully we won't have another lockdown, which means it's not going to be 5 months again before I can get it done again. Right, I'm home from the hairdressers now, and just had some tea. It's the first thing I've eaten all day, so I was absolutely starving, and it's a lovely evening because I've been sat on my backside for all afternoon. I'm going to put a jumper on and I'm going to go for a little walk, so that's probably going to be it from me tonight. And I'm still wearing the dress all day. It's lovely, really like it, but I'm definitely going to size down for the next one. In fact, I might go down 2 sizes, to be honest, because there is a lot of room in this dress. Hell of a lot of room, as you can see. So yeah. Hello and happy Wednesday. So home from work, just had tea, and I wanted to show you the cake we've got. It's Bronte's last week with us. She's going back to Leicester at the weekend. And so I thought, as a little treat, I would order another cake from my local friend's daughter, Millie, who, if you watched my vlog a few weeks ago, she did a Victoria sponge for us. And this week's order was a salted caramel and chocolate creation, which is just incredible. You've got to see this. There you go. So get a load of that. How amazing does that look? There must be thousands of calories in this. Yeah, so it's a good job I went for a run this morning. Yeah, so we're going to have a little piece of this, and yeah, it's really, really lovely. Had a good day at work, been on training this afternoon, which was really good actually. Taught me loads of new up-to-date info, which is very much appreciated. And I've had a little think about what I'm going to do next. I know I said the other day that I was going to do the Alba skirt, nicer over it, but I actually think I'm gonna make the Porto jumpsuit and also the Alexa jumpsuit by Tilly and the Buttons and compare the two. I like both of those patterns, and I thought it'd be a really good opportunity to make both and see which one I prefer. I'm losing weight, which is great, and so I feel a bit more confident making a jumpsuit and wearing it, which is the most important thing. Probably not so much after eating some of that over there though. So I think I'm going to get the Alexa. I've printed off the PDF pattern and I need to stick all that together, which is going to be a bit time consuming. But the Porto jumpsuit, obviously I got that printed out on the 8O pattern size. What are you doing?
Hello. Hello.
Okay. And.
Hello.
Oh dear, what do they say about not working with children and animals? Anyway, I'm going to trace out the Porto jumpsuit tonight, I think. And if I've got the energy, I might put together the the Alexa. Right, I'm just let me go kill my daughter. Right, so I'm up in my sewing room, which has been changed into Bronte's room while she's been here. She's tidied it. It looks amazing. I don't know if you can see just how tidy it is. Anyway, yes, I've had a delivery today of the bias binding. I think I mentioned it in last week's vlog when I was looking for the bias to finish off my Ravello dress. And I'd ordered some from eBay. And then obviously Bronte found some. So I ordered two lots because it was really reasonably priced, this bias binding. Somebody did ask me in last week's vlog, in the comments, where I bought it from. So obviously I didn't answer in the comments at the time because I hadn't received it and I wasn't sure obviously if I could recommend the seller or anything, but I always feel a bit, you know, odd about that until I've actually physically got things and can make a proper judgment on something. But it's arrived today, it looks fantastic. So I ordered two, they do it in all different colours. It's 19mm wide satin bias binding and it's £5.99 for a 25m roll. So I ordered the lovely teal colour, which is this gorgeous peacock blue. It's beautiful, really nice. And then I ordered navy. Now this to me looks more purpley blue than a proper navy, especially when I compare it to the blue that is on my Ravello dress. Having said that, it does say the colour is ink, not navy, so you know, I guess it's coming up true to the colour, real colour on screen, so I guess you could argue that that is ink. So that's probably just my fault more than anything, but otherwise, you know, they're really good. So I think I'm probably going to get some more. I just ordered those two to start with, but I will probably definitely order some more colours from them. So I will leave the link to the seller down below if you're interested. And I've come up here, we've just nipped out for a little walk just to try and walk off some of those calories from that beautiful cake. We just had a piece, it was beautiful. And I've come up to get my Porto jumpsuit and the Alexa jumpsuit patterns because I am going to put those together and get them traced off tonight, hopefully. What else? Last week's vlog, I edited it on Final Cut Pro. I think I mentioned last week that I'd been having problems with iMovie. I've had problems with it for ages and it's just so glitchy. It runs slow on my Mac and it just doesn't like it at all. My Mac is about 3 years old now, something like that, so it's not that old, but it just doesn't, it's just awful. And I was getting to the point where, I mean, some of my weekly vlogs, as you know, are about an hour long, and it was getting to the point where I was dreading having to edit them because it would take literally all night. And for those of you that vlog anyway, you will know that editing takes the longest part of vlogging. And that's when you've got things working well. So it was really frustrating me that I was having to spend so long editing. You know, I'd be starting, I'd literally get home from work, have my tea, then come upstairs and start editing the vlog, and it would be 10:30 before I'd be finished. And that's just not sustainable, to be perfectly honest. Not when I'm working as I am at the minute, and I've got obviously other commitments and, you know, my daughter here and everything else. So, yeah, I downloaded the free trial of Final Cut Pro and I had a bit of a play with it. I watched a YouTube tutorial actually on how to do the basics and everything that was an hour and a half long, so I watched that, and a lot of it is very intuitive compared to iMovie. If you've used iMovie, then yeah, a lot of it is very similar, but some of it is very different as well. And I'm not fully to grips with it yet, but I did edit last week's vlog using Final Cut Pro and it was fine. So I still think I've got loads to learn, and obviously it's a really big piece of software that you can do an awful lot with, which will probably take me a long time to get my head around. But I'm going to use it for the full length of the trial, which is 3 months, and then we'll see how it goes, because I know it's quite expensive to buy, you know, to unlock the full software and to buy it, but we'll see how it goes. Right, let me find these patterns and then we can go and trace them off.
Right, hi Mum. I'm doing this while you're at work so you don't see it, and I'm very aware that your camera's wonky but I cannot get it to stand up. So, I'm recording this because, as you know, I will be going home this weekend And I know you're going to find it very difficult because you've had me home for a month, and even when I'm home for a week, you get sad when I go home, so I have no idea how you're going to be now that I've been here a month. But I just wanted to let you know that I love you very much, and thank you for looking after me for the past 4 weeks and all your help. I'm going to really miss you, and it's going to be really weird being at home compared to being here. Because at least here, like, you genuinely do cook me my dinners and feed me. I'm going to have to now feed myself again, and I'm not looking forward to that. But I just wanted you to know that I love you lots and lots. And even when I'm back down there, even if I don't text you every day or ring you every day, it doesn't mean that I don't think about you and that I miss you, because I do. I always miss you, and I love you very much. So please don't cry when I go home, because I'll just be sad thinking Mum's gonna cry. Got to be happy. You get your sewing room back, you can put all your fabric back in there. But I love you very much.
Mwah. Yeah, had a fabric delivery. So I ordered some fabrics from Stitch Fabrics last week, and it's come today, which is really good. One of the fabrics, I wouldn't say I'm disappointed with it, but it's probably my fault for not reading the instructions very clearly. They had this gorgeous border print on their home screen of the website, and I really loved it. And I thought it was a drapey fabric, and it's not. It's quite heavyweight cotton. It feels almost upholstery weight, to be honest. So it's really structured, and I wanted to make some floaty trousers with it, which isn't going to be suitable. So I'm going to have to rethink that. But this is the fabric here. It's really lovely, gorgeous print, and then it's got this border print to the side. So I've got 3.5 meters of this to make some trousers, and if you look, you can see it's got like that quite loose weave, and it feels like a heavyweight, really quite heavyweight. You can see that there's not a lot of drape there. Really pretty, and I really like it. So I probably will be able to still make trousers, but they're going to be more structured and not quite the sort of silhouette that I was looking at, but we shall see. So that was the first one, and then I've been eyeing up this fabric for a while actually, and it was in the sale. It's really pretty. It's a georgette fabric, beautiful. This is the print here. It's very me, floral and dreamy and romantic. Really, really pretty. It's quite transparent because obviously it is georgette, which it did say that on the website, to be honest, but it recommended a plain georgette fabric to go with it, which was only £2 a meter, which is this one here. So those together do go, I mean, if I can just show you, they do go together really well, and I think with that behind it, it should be absolutely fine. There you go, you can just see that there. And the plan with this is to make a By at Hand London Anna dress. I've not made one of those for years, and I really fancy making the long version, and I think that will just look ever so pretty. So that's the plan for that, and that's why I bought this fabric to with that in mind. And then the final fabric was this jersey fabric, which feels a bit like a viscose jersey, but I think there's probably a fair bit of polyester in it. This is here. And I really like this print. I thought it was really pretty. So I've got a couple of meters of this as well to probably make, I'm not sure, I might make a cowl neck top actually. I think that would be quite nice. So, because it's got a nice drape to it. So, so that's been nice to come home to. Work has been busy today. I've had a really busy week at work, and Martin has picked up his new car today, so that's been exciting. So we've just been having a little play with that, and then I am going to trace off the sew over it Porto jumpsuit tonight. I was looking at the pattern and the finished pattern sizes a couple of nights ago, and it's actually got a lot of ease in it as that pattern, and I'm still hesitant on which size I want to trace off. Based on my body measurements, I should trace off between a size 12 and a 14, but if I do that, the amount of ease that's in there is enormous. I think it's something like 7 inches of ease around the bust and waist and even the hips, which seems a lot. So if I go by the finished measurements and allow myself a couple of inches of ease around each area, I should really go for probably the size 10. But again, I'm hesitant to trace off that as well, so I'm not quite sure. I think I'm probably going to go for the 12 because it's a good sort of compromise, and I'll use a fabric to start with that I am not too precious about and make a wearable 12. I think I'm going to do that. So that's been the first thing that's highlighted to me between the Porto jumpsuit and the Alexa jumpsuit, the amount of ease that is in each pattern. So I'm going to get that traced off tonight. The plan tomorrow is I need to go back to Walton's because the fabric that I bought for my daughter last week to make her pyjamas, I didn't get enough of because it's a directional print. So I've asked them to put another meter to one side. So I need to go back and get that. I also need some power mesh as well, which I didn't get as well. So that's the plan in the morning. I want to go for a good run in the morning as well, and then I am going to be sewing tomorrow. I am working on Sunday, but not till the afternoon, so I do have Sunday morning free. So that's the plan. Right, so it's Saturday afternoon and the sun is shining, as you can see. We are going to have a barbecue. Not sure if I mentioned that this morning actually, but we've just nipped to our local town and I've just picked up my two copies of Birder, which are June and July's, because the newsagent where she gets them for me has been obviously shut down for months, like everywhere. And yeah, we've just not been in to be able to pick them up, so I thought we'd have a little flick through. Right, so we'll look at June's first. I have had a quick flick through already, and where are we? Really like this jumpsuit, and this is the pattern that they sort of talk you through this month. I think each month they have a pattern that they provide really good instructions for. If I can actually find it, where are we? There we go. So yeah, they do a excuse the glass of Prosecco there. Yeah, they do a bit of a, you know, a proper detailed instruction walkthrough on how to make it, and this month it is that jumpsuit, but I really like it. I think that's really pretty, so definitely gonna make that at some point. The other things I like are where are we? That top. I think that top is really early 80s. I remember having a top like that when I was about 9. And the back of it is just shown there. I think that's really pretty, so I'm probably going to make that at some point as well. I also like this top, wherever it is. That one. I think that is gorgeous. Really love those pleats. It's really different. There's the line drawing there. But yeah, that's beautiful. Really like that. Definitely going to have a go at that. What else have we got? Simple tunic. Another shirt dress. I like the fabric. Not sure about those shorts. They're not really my kind of thing. Those shorts are quite nice though. Let's move on from the pattern sheets. Nothing else is sort of grabbing my eye at the minute. That's a bit of an odd top. It's got a different sleeve on one side to the other, so it's not really my kind of thing, I don't think. No. That's pretty, but it's very like the Sarast shirt that I made from Named Clothing. I mean, even the line drawing is very similar, so I probably wouldn't bother making that when I've already got a pattern for it. And then we've got the larger size range. It's nice to see them doing some fitted patterns for the larger size range, because I'm sure all you ladies that fit into the much larger sizes don't want to be dressed in tents all the time, so that's really good. And then children's patterns. Yeah, a couple of things in there I quite like. Let's have a look at July's. So, let's see. I'm not really sure about that. That's not really my thing. That top's not too bad. It's probably something that I would wear, but it looks very simple, to be fair. I think I've got things already like that. It's a nope so far. I do like these long line jackets, but they take some making to make them look really, really well executed. That's pretty, I quite like that. I do like that top, but I don't think that's actually one of the patterns. I like that skirt, that's nice. That top's quite pretty as well. It's very similar to the Alice top by Tasuti, which I'm wearing today, incidentally. I'm not sure about that one. I'll just move across the pattern sheets. Hoodie. It's just another hoodie. There's lots of hoodies about, lots of hoodie patterns. Looks quite nice in that. It's very simple to make, is that? I think that's literally two pattern pieces, looking at it. That'd be quite nice as a summer dress. Do like that skirt though. Yeah, that's really nice. Quite like that top. It's a bit different if you look at the line drawing. I like those pleating, that pleating. I like things that just look a bit different. Not sure about that. So, and this is the kind of thing I mean, you know, I mean, just because it's plus size, seriously? Yeah. Nice to see them doing some sort of fitted trousers for plus size, though. And another, you know, as usual, another t-shirt top. There are thousands of iterations of those around. Bit uninspiring, that one, actually. So but definitely a couple of patterns I like in there. Right, there is a martin, a lesser spotted martin, somewhere in the garden. I think you might just be able to see him. He's just bringing all the washing in. I've washed all my fabric from Walton's, and I think then we're gonna start on the barbecue.
Good morning, happy Monday. So I've totally missed out Sunday altogether. Yesterday I was working for a lot of it anyway, and in the morning I just had a really, really bad morning. My anxiety levels at the minute are through the roof, and yesterday morning was not good. So I didn't want to film, hope that's okay. But I had a week last week of no sewing at all. I mean, I have done some prep. I've prepped a couple of patterns, obviously. I've prepped the two jumpsuits, and I also printed out the Briar t-shirt by Megan Nielsen on Saturday. I don't think I showed you that because I did that quite late at night, and I've cut the fabric out. I did that yesterday morning, but that's it. I've not sewn a single stitch for a week, and that's not like me at all. But yeah, the Briar t-shirt, I want to make that pattern, obviously. I'm really sort of keen to have some more, when I say t-shirts, yeah, more casual tops in my wardrobe, but in plain fabrics. And I'm not a fan of the traditional sort of unisex type t-shirt, because I don't think it does anything for my figure at all. I don't find it particularly flattering. I think it's fine, obviously, if you tighten a knot at the front, but it's not something I would choose to make and wear, I guess, regularly. Although I do have a couple of ready-to-wear ones that I occasionally wear. But I wanted something that was sort of a bit like that, but a bit more interesting. And I think the Briar t-shirt, because it's got the curved front hem, I'll put a picture up,
fits that bill really. So I have cut out the cropped version, but as usual I've lengthened it by an inch, and I've cut it out in the Ray Stitch bamboo jersey that I bought to make the running top out of. But because it's so wide, I will be able to get another running top out of that as well, because it only uses 7/8 of a meter of, is that such a thing? 7/8, no, it's 7/8 of a yard, isn't it, of fabric. So, and even with the extra inch that I've added in, I'm still going to have enough to make one of those running tops out of. So I have got that cut out, and originally I had planned to sew that up yesterday morning before I went to work, but as I say, my anxiety was just through the roof yesterday morning and I wasn't fit to do anything. So anyway, that's still to be done. But I thought, obviously it's Monday morning, I'm going to be heading off to work soon, and this is my last 2 days at my locum, today and tomorrow it finishes, which I'm really actually pleased about. Originally I'd planned, I think, to carry on until to do Monday and Tuesday till the end of July, and then just do Mondays till we go on holiday at the end of August and then stop. But I'm actually glad that it's finishing now, because I really need some downtime. And so yes, yeah, so next Monday and Tuesday I'm not working at all, which I'm really looking forward to. It's going to be nice to have some time during the week where I can just do a bit of sewing, probably, because I'm not sure how much time I'm going to get this week coming either. Bronte is still with us. She's been here nearly 5 weeks now, but I think she's probably going to be going back this week at some point. Not sure when yet. But yeah, she needs to be getting herself back to work now. Her fitness has massively improved since she's been with us. She's a lot more chilled out, and it's lovely to see. So I'm really pleased that her health seems to be on the up now. And yeah, so she's going to be going back to Leicester at some point this week. But the reason I'm here before I go off to work today is because I've got some fabrics to show you. Now, these did come on Friday, and I just haven't had the chance to open them and show you what I got. So there's a couple of things. Now, some of this is totally Sian's fault. She totally made me do this, as she is quite a bit of an influencer, isn't she? Let's be honest, with some of her lovely fabrics. But a while ago, she bought some fabrics from Flamingo Fabrics, and I haven't bought from them for ages. And the fabrics she showed on a vlog, obviously I was like, oh wow, they're gorgeous and I need to get some, but they'd sold out at the time. But I contacted Dorota, who runs Flamingo Fabrics, and she was going to be getting them in again, and the pre-order came up and I ordered them last month and they came on Friday, which is brilliant. So they're all jerseys. One is a French terry, but the first one is this gorgeous leafy print with lemons on. It's beautiful, really beautiful. So I've got a meter of this with the, and it's upside down, always showing you these upside down, aren't I? I've got a meter of this and it's beautiful. Obviously it's going to be a top of some sort, not sure what yet. So that's that one. I also got this one as well, which is the Bird of Paradise and Monstera leaves. And again, this is a jersey. I think it's just a single jersey and it's gorgeous, quite vibrant. Again, I just got a meter of this because it's going to be tops again of some sort. And then I bought this French terry, which I think I got a meter and a half of this, with the plan to make a sweatshirt of some sort. Probably a cropped one, I think. Yeah, I got a meter and a half of this, but it's beautiful. If I just bring that in close, hopefully you can see that. It's like a paint splattered effect. Really pretty, and it's quite lightweight. Oh, just come back into focus. There we go. It's quite lightweight, but it's lovely. It'd be nice for, you know, a sort of lightweight summer sweater. So really pleased with that as well. And the other one that Sian made me buy as well, Stitch Fabrics, have some gorgeous fabrics in at the minute, and I showed you the ones that came the other day. Well, literally, I think the day that I'd ordered those, I watched Sian's vlog and she bought this beautiful leafy print fabric, and I was like, why didn't I see that on the website? So I had to go and place another order. So this is it here. It's a lightweight cotton sateen with birds and leaves, and I think I bought 4 meters of this, so it's beautiful. I'm saying it's a cotton sateen, it doesn't feel stretchy. There's no stretch to it whatsoever, so you know, it's going to be a dress of some sort, isn't it? So yeah, so that's that one. It's beautiful. So all these need to be washed yet. I was going to wash them over the weekend and I haven't had a chance. And then finally, the other two fabrics that I bought were from Sea Salt. Now, Sea Salt is a UK clothing company. They're based in Cornwall. They have, well, they came from Cornwall. They started off with shops in Cornwall and then they've expanded over the country over the last few years. But their aesthetic really is very Cornish vibes, if that makes sense. But they do fabrics as well, of a lot of what they make their garments out of. You can actually buy the fabrics, which is great. They're not cheap, but quite often they do deals. And at the minute they've got buy one, get 50% off. You can buy the fabrics in bundles of either a meter, 3 meters or 5 meters. And they do various bases. So they do some jerseys, they've got linens, they've got cotton voiles, which is very lightweight. They do needle cords as well, so they've got quite a variety, so it's always worth having a look. Well, I bought a couple of fabrics from them. They come in these nice little packages like this. So these are the two that I bought. This one is a linen, I believe. Yeah, it's called Tresco Fern Peacock, and I got a 3 meter bundle of this. So if I take this out of its little package, it's leaves, of course it's leaves. This is it here. So really pretty, and the plan originally was I was going to make another one of those button-up dresses, buying the folds I made last week that I showed you, but I need to tinker with that pattern because it's so big, but I think that would be really nice in that. So that's obviously going to go in the wash as well. And then this one is called Catch of the Day Cargo, which is 3 meters of, I think it's cotton voile. It's definitely cotton. Or is it cotton viscose? It might be cotton viscose actually. I will link to them down below anyway, so you can go have a look. But it's got boats on. Very Cornish, very seaside theme. Have I put that the right way? No, not learning, am I? There we go. So this is the print on this one. It's lovely. And I want to make a jumpsuit out of this because it's gorgeous. Really pretty. And yeah, so all those are going to go in the wash and get those hung out. Weather's a bit today. I think the plan is that there's going to be a massive heat wave down in the south of the country today, but we don't always, we don't always benefit from that up here in the north. And today it looks quite cloudy, but it's fairly mild, so hopefully the rain will hold off. But I am going to finish off getting ready and head off to work, and I will probably leave this here for this week and and start next week's vlog tonight when I get home. So I hope you've enjoyed what I have been up to this week, and I will look forward to seeing you again next week. Take care, bye.